雪般发送，雪般发送
，Savior of a song， Lover of a song，
We are on the wrong side， We will never give up。
My Lord, to feed for your table. Daddy, as we are gathered this morning, we are gathered unto thee and not unto any man. Father, O Lord, come and feed us again this morning with your word, with that your undiluted word from the throne of grace. At the end, we shall all be blessed. Father, I, O Lord, send myself unto this morning. Father, use me, O Lord, to my honor of your name, as you know other ministers in the ministry, that the end will be glorified. Father, I have no words of my own. Daddy, Lord, put your word again in my mouth that will benefit every one of us that will glorify your name at the end. Father, we thank you, Lord, that they are coming against, Lord, every spirit, Lord, of distraction, every mind, Holy Spirit, every spirit of confusion. I hold them bound and I cast them away from the vicinity in the name of Jesus Christ. And let your fire, Lord, come down, Lord, to all, Lord. So teach us your word again this morning, that the end will be glorified. Thank you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, for in Jesus' mighty name I have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Brethren, we are before the Almighty God once again this morning. Hear this word, and the title of our short word of this morning is titled "Beware of End Time Deception." Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the literary context, the meaning of deception is an act of making someone to believe something which is not true. Praise the Lord. Deception is an act of making someone to believe something which is not true. Amen. And these days, we have seen so many things begin to unfold which are not true, but are very, 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 the way it will be presented before you, you think they are true, but they are not true. Let's turn over to the book of Matthew, chapter 24. I read from verses 3 to 5, Matthew 24, verse 3. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciple came unto him privately, saying, Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of the coming and of the end time of the world? 4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you. 5. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive you, shall deceive many. Praise the Lord. Our Lord Jesus Christ was the one talking to his disciples here, teaching them or letting them to know the signs of the end time, that what is going to come after he must have left this world. And today we are beginning to see so many people have claimed to themselves that they are Christ. Some have said they are the living perfect master. Some have come with different names to deceive so many children of God. And so many have come to tell us that outside their ministry, there's no other ministry where somebody can be led to heaven. And which are all false, woman, they are all lying, because no one of them knew the time and the hour. Even Christ himself said, no, I don't know the time, even the hour with which the rapture shall come. Praise the Lord. And in the same verse, that same Matthew 24, we read verse 24 of it. Verse 24 says, for there shall arise false Christ and false prophet, and shall show great signs and wonders, such as much that if it were possible, they shall be deceived, and the very elect. Praise the Lord. Today, even the people that were born again yesterday, that were filled with the Holy Spirit of God, that when you see them, you begin to admire them. Many have been, you know, taken away by false rumor, by false prophecy, by false, you know, revelation. And by so doing, today the world is into defaulting into so many problems because of lack of understanding the spirit of the word of God. Praise the Lord. And I pray that as we are gathered on this mountain day after day, that God Almighty is going to empower us and inspire us with this word, that no one can come again with the tongue to deceive us anymore, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
And in the book of 1 John chapter 4, I read verse 1. 1 John chapter 5, verse 1. It said, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Seen on this mountain how many people have, you know, come to confront the man of God. Yeah, this man says so, this one says so, and so many of them have, you know, left because of lack of understanding, because they want to be told that tomorrow you are going to become the president of Germany, tomorrow you are going to become the chancellor of Germany, or tomorrow you are going to become the prime minister of Britain, and which have forced, you know, revolution. And by such doing, so many people have got offended, so many people have, you know, been misled, so many have been led astray, and so many people, you know, yesterday, they are now beginning to tell you things which are not supposed to be. And by so doing, so many have slept, according to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 20, about, said many people slept, many people have been, they have eaten the blood of Jesus Christ, and they are drinking, we said, to the direction of their self, because they lack understanding of the word of God. Praise the Lord. But here this morning, the Lord God Almighty himself is warning you and I, is telling us what is to come, and which we have all seen, and we have all experienced, and we are still experiencing today. So, brethren, let us beware that the end time is here, and the devil is out there to take as many as possible from the kingdom of God, because some of us are already, you know, we are looking at things which are not supposed to be. We are seeing things which we know that is not true, but we are believing them because we lack the understanding of the word of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Of John chapter 5, the book of John chapter 5, I read from verses 39 to 47. John chapter 5. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I read 39. It said, search the scripture, for they ye think they have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me. 40. And they will not come to me that ye might have life. I receive not honor from men, but I know you that ye have not the love of God in you. 43. I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive it not. If another shall come in his own name, ye will receive him. Praise the Lord. Today, people have come with different names, different, you know, under the pretense of being Christ, under the pretense of being the God, Almighty and people have, you know, gone within a mouth. And I know that God Almighty is not a liar. He said a sword that the God of the our God is not the Son of Man that name to repent, that will he lie to us. Praise the Lord. And if we read from 5 down, say, do not think that I will accuse you from the Father. There is one that accuses you, even Moses, in whom they trust. Christ is not the one to accuse you on that day. It is that man, Satan the devil, that will stand before the throne of grace and begin to tell the Father all that he knows about the people that have taken, that he has taken away. Praise the Lord. Because today, most people, they think they are serving God. They think what they are doing, they are right with God, and not knowing that Satan has already brought them over. Satan has already taken them over. Praise the Lord. But on that last day, they'll be surprised to see that all they've been doing is nothing, but they have been working for Satan, the devil, their master. Praise the Lord. The other day, the last night, the man of God was, you know, emphasizing on baptism, on so many things, which some people today, they don't know. So many Christians today have been baptized to the marine kingdom. They have been sold to the marine power, but only to them. And on that last day, if something is not done, they will be surprised that all the ground they have been standing, they have been standing in the ground of the devil, their master, the Lord. And they will know that even everything about them, they are already be sold to the devil because of lack of understanding the word of God. Praise the Lord. Please go with me to the book of Colossians, chapter number 2. I read Colossians chapter 2, praise the Lord. I read from verses 8 to 9, Colossians chapter 2. I read, it said, beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the readiness of the world, and not after Christ. Today, so many people have been, you know, taken away, they have been deceived, they have been captured by men prophecy. And don't worry, the child you are looking for, this time next year, you're going to give birth to a baby boy or baby girl. And not knowing even the very children they're talking about are being brought from the sea. Praise the Lord. And that's why today we see in the world today, so many things are going on. There are so many confusion. You see some children today, you think they are, you know, they are like cow, they are like dog. On the street, the way they behave, the way they shout, you know that these ones are not, you know, human being. Praise the Lord. Because of the lack of the word of God. Because we lack patience, we lack understanding the word of truth. Amen. And verse 9 said, for in him dwelleth all the fullness of Godhead bodily. 10. And ye are complete in him, which is the head of all prophecy and power. But today, nobody wants to know that. None of us want to understand that everything in this world consists of the word of God. And without the word of God, nothing was made that was being made. But today, people want to do things out of their own personal volition, without direction, without understanding, without even knowing what they are doing. But at the end, they will stand to tell you what I did was right. I was justified in my action. Don't worry. On that last day, we shall know who is righteous with God and who is justified with their action. Praise the Lord. And in that same Colossians chapter 2, I read verse 18 of it. It says, let no man beguile you of your reward in a voluntary humility and worshipping of an angel, intruding into those things which he hath not seen, veiling proof of by his fleshly mind. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Today, many people, they are whatever they are doing it out of selfishness, out of their fleshly desire, out of what they have not in their heart. We have seen today, you know, little doctors who are now calling themselves Reverend Father, they call themselves Bishop, they call themselves, you know, evangelist, all in the name to deceive the children of God. And because of the false, you know, prophecy that they gave, because of the fictitious, you know, signs and other things they do, people are falling down en masse. And I begin to wonder the kind of people who they are, or if they actually understand what they are doing. Amen. I pray that God Almighty will show himself to them, because his wish for us all is not to perish on that last day, but to come to his rest. Amen. Amen. And please turn into the book of First Timothy chapter 4. I read First Timothy chapter 4. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. First Timothy chapter 4, I read from verses 1 and 2. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in later days or later time some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirit and doctrine of devils, to speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience stirred up with a hot iron. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What have we not seen? People today are beginning to, you know, to blaspheme against the name of our Christ. They are beginning to, you know, to say us all manner of things. People are now beginning to, you know, to seduce, you know, children of God with bring things, with deceitful spirit. They have been sold away because of their selfish desire, because of lack of understanding, because they want to be like they want. I want to be like Brother Peace. I want to be like Apostle Manuel. Forgetting that the gift of God varies. What God had deposited in Apostle Manuel, or Brother Peace, or Brother Mecca, or Stadigbe, is different from what He had deposited in you. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
We are all one in the body of Christ, but with different functions that He has given to each and every one of us. Everybody cannot be a prophet at the same time. Everybody cannot be, you know, an evangelist at the same time. He has given to you and I different offices which we must operate. When Moses was alive, Joshua was there, but Joshua never knew that he was the one that would take over from Moses after his departure. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. And Joshua never began to put himself in the shoe of Moses while Moses was alive. But today, everybody, because we can, you know, read Bible verses, because we can teach in Sunday school, we now become person of founder without directives, without instruction from God. And by so doing, because of that selfish desire, many people have gone astray to start looking for help where help does not exist. So many pastors today have started going to native doctor to go and get power to deceive the children of God. Forgetting that on that last day, both day, and the source of their power will be consumed in hellfire. And I pray that as many people who are still, you know, indirectly or secretly calling pastors they don't know, pastors they don't know their spiritual standing, you don't even know him, because he can tell you, God bless you, on the phone, he's the man of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I remember a friend of mine in Facebook, you know, he wrote something on the Facebook, and somebody I knew very well in Germany here began to write him and began to call him man of God. And the guy just came to me and we were just laughing. Said, bros, if you want to deceive this man now, I can eat his money. Because he's calling man of God. And the boy he's calling a man of God is somebody he knew very well because of the article he wrote on Facebook. Praise the Lord. And that's how today many people have been deceived, many people have been misled because of ordinary God bless you. And now begin to tell him all your life history. You begin to tell him how your father got married to your father and to your wife and to your mother and how you give birth to and everything. And at the end of the day, you'll be robbed of your hard earned money. I pray that God Almighty will instruct us and open our eye and ear to hear and to see from him continually in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Brethren, come with me again to the book of John chapter. I read John chapter 14, praise the Lord. John 14, verse 6. John 14, verse 6, I read. It said, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but me. But today, there are so many people that will tell you, I know when Christ is going to come. I know the date, the time, and the hour. I can even take you there, no problem. If a man can be able to tell a pastor that I will take you to a place where you get anointing that no matter what you do, you will not be defiled. Then the same man can also take you and can tell you that I know when Christ is going to come and I know the time, the hour, and the date. Praise the Lord. Because we are beginning to see different things today. We are beginning to see so many, you know, prophets, so many pastors who have already, you know, given themselves, who are already volunteered to be used by the devil. No matter the circumstances, no matter the situation, they don't want to know. All they are after is they want to be, they want that 5 minutes famous. They want to be known. I'm a prophet. I'm an evangelist. I'm a reverend father. All in the name of making, you know, hot money and die in the next 5 seconds. And people are going there en masse. People are trooping to their churches because they want to be told, you know, false lie. Praise the Lord. I pray that God Almighty has brought this mountain for us to hear his word, for us to be told the truth day after day. He will continue to sustain us with his word and with his undiluted, you know, word day after day in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Please
come with me to the book of Jeremiah chapter 17. Praise the Lord. I read Jeremiah 17 from verses 7 to 13. Praise Pastor Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I read. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Read from verse 7 to 13. Jeremiah 17. Amen.
Amen.
Praise Pastor Jesus. 13.
Amen.
He said, O Lord, praise the Lord. Sorry.
Amen.
Said, this is the man that trusted in the Lord and whose hope, Lord, is. Verse 8. Said, for he shall be as a tree planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out her root by the river, and shall not see when heat cometh, but her leaf shall be green and shall not be colorful in the years of drought. Neither shall cease from yielding fruit. If you abide in the word of truth, if you abide in the holiness of God and righteousness of God, the Lord is telling us here that you shall be like a tree planted by the riverside that bringeth fruit his that bringeth forth his fruit, whether in season or out of season, and your leaf will never go dry, meaning that you will never be, you know, in want. You will not be in lack, because you dwell in the forehead of the word of God. But for as many that have decided to go after deceit, after, you know, a fake prophecy, he said in verse 9, he said, the heart is deceived above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? For I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the rein, even give every man according to his own ways and according to the fruit of his doing. 11 said, as the partridge sitteth on egg and hatcheth them not, so he that getteth riches and not by right shall leave them in the midst of his days, and his end shall be a fool. Praise the Lord. 12 said, a glorious height, a glorious high throne from the beginning is the place of our sanctuary. Our Lord, the hope of Israel, shall forsake thee, shall be ashamed, and they that depart from me shall be written in the earth, because they have forsaken the Lord, the fountain of living waters. Praise the Lord. As many that have, you know, despised the word of God, as many that have despised Satan, as many that have taken after the doctrine of men, they shall be forgotten on the earth. They shall burn in the lake of fire and brimstone. They shall be consumed in hellfire, because they have forsaken the word of God, because they have forsaken the truth of the word of God. No matter what they are running after now, the kind of money they want to make now, they want to be like Aliko Dangote. They want to be like Bill Gates. They want to be like Packer. No problem. On that last day, he will tell you, you know the way Elijah Abiola went, the way pornography went, and the way Packer went. Praise the Lord. Because what we are seeing now, our eyes is closed. We are seeing the different thing, and we think that is the end of it all. But I pray that God Almighty will help us all, that on that last day we will not go the way they went, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
And in the book of Proverbs chapter 14, I read verse 25. Proverbs 25, I read, it said that a true witness is so, but a deceitful witness speaketh lies. Praise the Lord. Amen. We have seen so many lies have been said to the ear of the children of God, and because of the lie they have heard, they have run after them, not knowing that their end up is destruction. Because of pregnancy, someone to get pregnant, they have run to India to go and get children that have been given from the Marine Kingdom. So many people have run to so many places because of, you know, a job seeking, they have gone to sow their soul to the Illuminati. So many people want to know, because of acting, they have sold themselves to the devil, and so many things have taken them over. And on that last day, God Almighty is waiting for them all. Because no matter what you say now, no matter what you do now, they see you as somebody who's not serious. But the end justifies the means, according to the English men. Praise the Lord. And lastly, just turn to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4. I read from verses 1 to 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, the last verse for today, because of time. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Please, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, I read from verses 1 to 3. It said, therefore, saying we have this ministry. As we have received mercy, we faint not too, but have announced, the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. And three, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. Praise Master Jesus. The word of God is open to everybody, everyone of us on this mountain. But it is hidden from those ones that are lost, who don't want to hear the word of God, who don't want to hear the undirected word of God, who don't want to hear the truth from the truth of grace. They are lost, and they are lost forever. But for those of us that are of this mountain, please let us be able to, as much as we can, to spread the gospel news of the word of God, and end. God Almighty will be happy with us and will be blessed with us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The word of God says that we all should preach the word of God, not the little, and a word is enough for the wise. And I pray that all God Almighty will strengthen us, keep us, and see us through on the last day in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
What to the man of God?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.